Hi, I am cutting bed of roses, and it's now Monday, and I made this on Friday. This is where impatience gets you, because I unmolded sooner than I normally do, for one, and for two, I knew I should wait, but I was not feeling very patient. So anyway, yeah, of course, screwed up the corners and a couple, well, this side especially, it kind of stuck in the mold. And this is a full water soap, so, you know, it's a little softer than if I was to reduce the water. So it was just my fault, but that's all right. That's, you know. You need to learn to be patient. It's just, I'm always dying to see what the soap looks like all of us. So anyway, there's a little owie in the corner there on this one. So, let me break that little piece off. So there you go. Turned out cute. There again, this was the blobbing, and then I stirred it with the, got an air pocket there. It was a little thick, and I stirred it with the chopstick. Like I said, I mean, I should have been patient, and I wasn't, and that's where it got me. We always just want to see what the inside of the soap looks like. This is kind of... I have these embeds pretty close to each other, so... But they're good-sized bars, and I like that. With them being short, you know, they're a good width. If you can see that, if I'd stay in the camera, that'd be nice. But anyway, I like the swirl. Ooh, that looks cool. Cool. I just love those little leaves with the roses. They just go perfect, so I'm glad I did it. As tedious as it was, doing the little teeny, teeny, tiny things. It was worth it. See, they just look cute in there with the rose. This is going to be a very tight fit. Can I do this? I hope. Oh, perfecto. Thank goodness. Ooh, got a bigger pocket there in that one. I had a feeling that was going to happen because it was a bit on the thick side. And I didn't smack it down super hard. That's another difference too. Really, I could have smacked it down a lot more. I just didn't. Shoulda, woulda, coulda. I like the glitter on top. Glitter always makes everything cuter. It was funny, I was watching videos yesterday, and I thought, you know, I need to make some soaps without embeds, as much as I love to do them. I have not made, I think, let's see. Last time I did make soap without an embed, or the embeds in them, was the Seahawk soap, and that was a while ago. So, I need to do that sometime. I think it'd be nice. I do like the way they look. And not everybody wants embeds, but I enjoy making them, so. And these aren't all going to be exactly the same size bars. They'll be very, very close, but not exactly. Now the teal color, I was trying to match the roses as much as possible in the colors, but I didn't do the pink quite as dark as the flowers, or the purple for that matter. And the teal is darker than the flowers. So the purple pink are not as dark as the flowers, and the teal is darker than the flowers, so. But it still looks really cute. I think it turned out great. I love it. I like to do the blobbed soap and then stir it. I love the way that makes it look. Now these are loaded with butters, so cocoa butter is very, you know, it's a pretty hard butter, so that kind of helps, but yeah. Let's see up close. Cute. A couple of the leaves I did them a lot lighter. I was going to kind of alter them, but since you have to do them, like, I was doing them literally three at a time, like mixing the, you know, soap form three at a time. So it wasn't like I had a huge, I used the same batch for all of the leaves. So then what I'll try to, oh, I don't think I'm going to be able to do that without ruining the flower. Yeah. I'll skip it. See, this is the back side, and this got a little stuck in the mold, so this one's a little flawed. But I can run it on a planer later. That'll be easier than trying to cut it, because if I cut it, see, this side here is going to get cut off. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching. Hope you're having a great day. See you in the next video. Bye.